something happening in the area. There's something happening everywhere, yo. There's something happening in the area. Come on, let's get moving and let the bala go. Yo! Come on, let's get grooving and hear the hala ho. Now we're really booming, we're gonna get some more. Give me more, give me more.
Everybody on the floor!
Come on, let's get swaying, we're running with the flow.
Yo!
Come on, let's get waving, we're gonna steal the show.
Ho!
Now we're really playing, we're gonna win some more. Give me more, give me more.
Everybody on the floor!
So low, just let it go. Come and the game.
There's something happening in the air.
Go with the flow.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's just a game, right? Anybody who has not experienced a thrilling last-minute victory or an agonizing last-ball loss would utter these words about the game of cricket. And for everyone else, it is life, and we live it in this country every moment. St. Aloysius Institutions, St. Aloysius Autonomous College, has always taken it as a matter of pride to support the sports and that too cricket. And today there's a new milestone as we are going to inaugurate St. Aloysius Cricket Academy. And as a part of that program, we have a very special program here, the Crick-Chat with Mr. David Johnson. We are already joined by the dignitaries on this occasion. They are Reverend Father Melwin Pinto SJ, Rector of St. Aloysius Institutions, Reverend Dr. Praveen Martis SJ, the Principal of St. Aloysius Autonomous College, Mr. David Johnson, former international cricketer, Ms. Shanti Mohan, the president of Karavali Cricket Academy, Ms. Savita Miskit, vice president of Karavali Cricket Academy, Mr. Dayanand Bangera, former international player who has represented UAE in international cricket, Mr. Jayaprakash Shetty, former player of Karnataka Premier League. Can we have a round of applause for all our guests? We are happy to have them. It's a very warm welcome to you all on behalf of our college as well as Karavali Cricket Academy. A special welcome goes to our friends from media and all the cricket players and cricket lovers. Before we proceed, we have an AV on the chief guest and his introduction. Let's have a look. A country where the game of cricket is considered as religion and cricketers as guardian angels. Karnataka has always had a rich legacy of producing international cricketers. Erappalli Prasanna, Bhagavat Chandrasekhar, Gundappa Vishwanath, Syed Kirmani, Anil Kumble, Jargil Srinath, Rahul Dravid, and an Aloysian himself, KL Rahul, are the shining stars who made Karnataka and India proud. There's one more name which easily fits into this elite list. In an era where no speed gun was available to measure the velocity of ball, this man had a knack of bowling at 150 kilometers per hour. It's our privilege to have him as our chief guest today. Former India Test cricketer David Jude Johnson. Born in Arsikere, a small town of Hassan district, David Johnson pursued his BCom studies from renowned Jesuit institution St. Joseph's College, Bangalore. He had his breakthrough Ranji season in the year 95-96 with Karnataka and soon made his debut for India at Delhi
It was against Australia under the captaincy of Sachin Tendulkar. And then came his big moment when David Johnson had Australian opener Michael Slater caught at slips by Mohammad Azharuddin.
He's done it again and out. What a catch! Absolutely outstanding by Mohammad Azharuddin. And the words of Jeffrey Boycott, prophetic.
Well, what a catch when we see that again by Azharuddin. But what a shot, look at it. It's nearly a wide. An atrocious shot. Brilliant catch, atrocious shot.
Jeff Boycott's commentary made this moment memorable for all Indian fans. He played for two seasons for Team India and also bagged 125 first-class wickets to help Karnataka to clinch many titles. In last few years, David Johnson has actively involved himself in coaching. As a coach in prestigious National Cricket Academy, he has trained budding cricketers. In 2018, he served as the head coach of Uttarakhand State Women's Team. Currently, he is the owner and head coach of David Johnson Cricket Academy, Bengaluru. His noble cause of helping the kids to realize their dream of being professional cricketers also resonates with the motto of St. Aloysius Institution's Lucid et Ardet, Shine to Enkindle. Mr. David Johnson, it's an honor to have you as the chief guest for launching of St. Aloysius Cricket Academy, and alongside the Karavali Cricket Academy, we all Aloysians accord a warm welcome to you.
Unfortunately, nowadays we don't have academies like this. Like, we have plenty of academies. Every click in every corner there's academies. Run by some good academies and somebody just for the sake of running academy. We didn't have that. And leather ball cricket was really too difficult in that time. To be honest, in the 80s, in 85s we come around leather, we had a good leather ball team to play leather ball. So basically I'm also a tennis ball cricketer. So we come from that.
So to what age you were into only tennis ball, sir?
Till I was 18.
Till you were 18 you didn't even touch the season ball?
No, I was just a cop.
So what was the breakthrough moment then?
It was again a tennis ball game we were playing, and I got 7 wickets under floodlight, and there was one Samuel Sheriff who was already playing under 23 for the state. And that guy was the one who forced me, and because of him I'm sitting here and I became an individual, to be honest, let's get with that. So he was the one who came away to my house and forced me, and I refused the guy. I told my mom, this guy is cracked. I can't be going so far to Manjur. And I was staying in Ashwanpurella colony. So it was a little bit too far for me those days. I didn't know Manjur, so I hadn't seen it. So, to be honest. So then I had to go to Chidasami Stadium, which I didn't want to do. But he didn't let me. He came, he picked me, took me, and went. And unfortunately, I went past him, and he got out of the night.
All right, that's great. And can you just take us through about your college days and then your journey to Karnataka Ranji team?
To be very honest, college days was, I was already in the team by the time, so I now went to college much, and St. Joseph's always encouraged us to go play a game, and that's another reason I'm sitting here, I could say.
St. Joseph's also has produced many other international...
Many, Rahul. There are so many cricketers, you can name so many of them, Ranji Trophy especially, there's plenty of them. And the father who was there at our period of time, he just wanted us to play, not come to college. See, this college, he used to just go back to practice.
Okay, and your breakthrough moment in your Ranji cricket, maybe at what age you got into the Karnataka Ranji cricket team, sir?
It was about 23, 24 I was.
So within 4 years of starting your professional coaching, you're playing for Karnataka?
Yeah, within my very first year when I started playing, I played pentangulars. And okay. That year itself, I got selected for under 19 straight away, the last year of under 19. And the very next 2 years, I was in the team. It was very quick, in fact.
Okay, for us it is a big deal because you are, okay, nonchalantly saying that. Your contemporaries, the players with whom you shared the dressing room in Karnataka Ranji team, who were your contemporaries?
P.V. Shishikant was my roommate when I got in first. So for many years, for 5 years, he was my roommate. And then when he got off, then Avin Ashwadiya was there. We used to gel very well because of the food habits, you could say, and stuff. So we all used to have a lot of fun, and so he was a good roommate to me.
Okay. And then this dream moment of getting an India call. So it was told us from our research, we found out that Jagdal Srinath got injured for some reason, and one person's misfortune was your fortune. How could you cherish that particular moment?
It's a great moment. Play for the country is nothing bigger than that. So, but the time when I got in, Srinath was injured, yeah, like you said. But somebody has to give in way for the other person. So it doesn't matter how it comes, you can have it in both hands. But unfortunately, I was told the day I was playing, the game that I was playing.
So but that morning you got to know?
I was not prepared at all for it. So okay. It was still a tough task, but I still managed to do it.
Do you remember who gave you your test cap?
Sachin Tendulkar.
Sachin Tendulkar gave you your test cap. So that's great. Alright, and as we saw in that video, that Azharuddin took a great catch, and then you got a chance to go to South Africa as well in the next tour. Alright, so our next thing is we say, for in every field we need to have role models. There's always an allegation, especially in Indian cricket, that we have great batsmen, great spinners, but when it comes to fast bowling, we do not produce enough fast bowlers. Pakistan, Imran Khan, superstar, and even now they have a fast bowling factory. What do you think, you know, what has gone wrong when it comes to India? Of course, we have Jasprit, Bumrah, Zaheer Khan, one or two. But considering our domestic structure, I guess we could have done much better.
See, the first basic reason is that in India, you know that it's very difficult to bowl fast bowlers. Hardly any wickets we do prepare for the fast bowlers. So wherever you go, it's a dry wicket, it's a batsman's game. It's been the batsman game from all these years. When the game started, it's a batsman game. As it's going on, you are seeing now, they are robots today. Today's cricketers, where can you hit them? Being a aggressive fast bowler like myself, you want to hit the batsman very often, to be honest. So you don't get a chance nowadays to do it, because they cover their whole body. So not many youngsters are trying to be fast bowling. And again, it's the associations and the BCCI to take up this to make sure that they make fast bowlers. And at least our young crop, our new generations, starts playing on these fast wickets.
Are you happy with the present lot? Because now at least we say, Jasprit Bumrah, Mohammad Shami, Mohammad Siraj, we have got those intimidating bowlers who can scare the opposition with the bouncers, and that was not to be seen for many years, and that's perhaps a key to our success in the last 2 years.
Very true. Now these bowlers, they are really very good there. But again, for the future, you've got to prepare again. See, after these guys, you're in the under-19 level and the under-17 level, and I don't see many of these fast bowlers. So we've got to take care of that now. So that we get, these fast bowlers are going to last, and especially fast bowling, you can't last long. So you got to get the new crop ready for it.
Need to have that vision ahead. Our next question is with regard to the small town players making it to the big level. When KL Rahul was studying in Aloysius PUC, he was already playing for under-19, and his training was basically in our Centenary ground. Or maybe even for that matter, when MS Dhoni got selected from a small town called Ranchi, many eyebrows were raised, because for a large period of time, cricket means Bombay, Madras, Bangalore and Delhi, that's it. So how do you see this transition? Are there any positive changes in this regard, that small town boys getting better opportunities?
Perfectly. Now we can, with all the academies opening, and see now we are opening a new academy. This has all definitely helped the guys from here, so to show the talent, and if they really well got the talent, like Rahul was extraordinary, he's got extra talent than others. So you will definitely get opportunities to get picked, and guys to see you. You don't have to come for Bangalore for a tournament. People are coming to you now, and especially even the KSCA and the BCCA for that matter. We are putting camps all over India, and even small towns we go and we get the big cricketers and we train them.
Okay, and the support we have, at least now we see there are many players who have been employed. Maybe last 20, 30 years this trend is there, the private banks, and they come forward and offer the jobs. What do you reckon the support given by our government players? Because we talk about maybe there's one Rahul, but there could be hundreds who wanted to be a Rahul and they didn't make it. So what is our backup plan? Are you happy, or can we do much better when it comes to offering jobs to our domestic players? Because everybody will not make it to Indian team, or they will not get an IPL contract.
Very true. The jobs opportunities are very less nowadays. In fact, actually, when we were playing and we used to earn one Ranji Trophy, you get a bank job straight away. Nowadays, that also has changed. It's become much difficult now to get a job. So what is it? When they're playing, the opportunities, the banks, what they used to do those days, they should start that again. And now it has become very less, and with the banks all merging, teams also become less. So it's difficult. It's a tough day. You've got to work hard for everything you get.
So you, by the, when we speak about this, you have also travelled overseas and visited other countries as well. When you compare their system, they say if they spot a talent, a 6 or 7 year old boy, they'll make sure they'll take care of him for next 20, 30 years. So what is that strength, and you know, how can we learn something from them? Australia, South Africa, England for that matter.
Very true, they're a little ahead of us, I can say. But again, from the last couple of years now, after Dravid coming to the NCA and Ganguly taking over, then you go to Kerala. Kerala, they got all camps for women cricketers all over. It's not one district or one place that they don't have a camp. They have camp, they encourage the women cricketers also, plus the male free cricketers. Everybody has to do it. The whole country has to do it for you to go.
But in any case, signs are encouraging. That's what you are saying. All right, so we'll move on to the technical part now. Did you ever have any information about a sports nutrition or diet in your playing days?
Water or glucose, that's all.
Water and glucose. Okay. So at least with that regard, the present lot is lucky that right from their early days, they're getting the information, what to eat, what not to eat.
Very true, but I have a concern in that also, because too much of information also is too bad, like we say. So nowadays, you see, we lasted for 10 years without anybody training us, without even doing gym, without doing nothing. It's just what we knew, run. Run 20 kilometers, run around this, run around that, that's all we knew. We lasted, but nowadays you show me which fast bowler lasts for 10 years.
After every series, they take break for next 2 series.
With all your nutrition, with all your gym, all your coaches next to you, one carrying your bag,
yeah.
You don't last for 5 years.
That's my next question, because I just got to know, when our team visited South Africa, there were 18 players and there were as many as 13 support staff members for everything. So sometimes is it like, you know, too much things also, or is it the order of the day?
It's a very easy and good saying for the beginning when you say in English. Yep. Too many cooks spoils the dish.
Yeah, all right, that's your opinion. Okay, one more skill they say, when we had Raghuram Bhatt here, and he was sharing his experience of facing the West Indies fast bowlers, and I asked this question to him, did they ever sledge you? And he said, no, they just looked at me and that was more than enough. So what was your experience? Do you think sledging is overrated, or within certain boundaries it is okay?
It's okay in certain boundaries. It keeps some guys got the habit of doing that, and say like myself, I also sledge a lot. At that time sledging was not there, but I used to do it in Ranji Trophy. It was not more than I can say sledging, it was just to pump myself up.
It's not an abuse for that matter.
It's not abuse, it's just pushing myself up, back to bowl the rest, to go quicker, or just go after you. But when the batsman doesn't retally, then you actually lose the battle.
Hmm. Do you remember any international batsman or even a domestic legend whom you sledged and he gave it back to you? Any one particular incident, if you could share something? I know these are not caught by the cameras.
No, nobody. I don't think so.
You don't want to share it, we'll put it that way. All right. We were astonished, because for us, cricketer's life is pretty glamorous. At least those who get IPL contract and those who get the international contract. You know, we were astonished by the fact that even in such a glamorous world, people like Ben Stokes, Glenn Maxwell gave the reason that they're willing for a break because they have got mental health issues. But for us, everything looks so glamorous and charming. So what could be the issues which are bothering these professional cricketers who are earning in crores, they've got fame, they've got fan following?
See, it's too much of cricket. To go to see that throughout the year they are playing some way or the other, and again the mental stress, they have families back down. So it'll sort of get to you after some time. See, when we played, there were a lot of breaks there. Nowadays, you go for a tour, after 3-4 months, you don't have another tour. But now it is everyday cricket, it's cricket and cricket. And so certain people, it doesn't get to everybody, certain people with some family problems.
The burden of expectations also, yes, all right. And talking about the money, a person who is maybe hardly getting some thousands or lakhs, and all of a sudden he gets an IPL contract, and overnight he could be earning 3 crore, 4 crore. In one point of view, they say it's good, because that's a reward for his efforts all these years. But one more point of view is, if it's given at such a tender age, then he might lose focus. I'm referring in this context, like I read it, Vinod Kambli played his last match for India at the age of 24, and by then he had 2 double centuries and he never played for India.
See, when it comes to Vinod, it's again his own fault, I can say, so I can't get into that, so I'll just leave it there. But when it comes to the money part of it, yeah, what you say is right. When the youngster gets a big contract, again, he can definitely lose it, but again, it's all for the youngster sitting here also. You should have the heads on the shoulder. Money doesn't buy you. And with money, you can't get what you respect you earn and what you're going to become. If the cricket has given you a name, it's made you IPL cricketer or Indian cricketer, you've got to perish that. Money is nothing towards it.
All right. There's also a question. What is the remuneration structure of a domestic cricketer? Now, tomorrow, if one of these people gets elected into Karnataka state and never makes it to the higher level, but can his parents and family say, okay, our son is playing for the state and our life is done? Are we in that position, realistically speaking?
No, we're not in that. But the payment according to us when we started off, it was the 750 for a Rens Trophy game.
750 rupees?
Yes.
Okay.
And when I left at 2000, it was just 3,500. Okay. Now it is, I think, 40,000, 50,000 a day. So it's pretty decent. It's picking up. It's coming up.
From 750 to match to 40,000 a day. So
it's 40 or 50 there.
Okay, yeah. That's the thing. For some reasons, do you think it's a batsman's game, this cricket? Let's say now, even if I overstep, there's a free hit coming for the next ball. Or there's no concept of reverse swing at all because they are playing with two new balls in a one day. So there's no question after 30 overs, the ball will become old and there's reverse swinging. And moreover, if you do something out of the box, there's something called man-cutting. And then it becomes an issue of ethics versus rules. So there's absolutely no mercy on bowlers. Is it a batsman's game? Do you think the game is partial towards batsmen?
It's always been a batsman game, like I told you. Leaving the early parts of the 70s, after the 80 and 91, the helmet and all the other rules came, so batsman's game. But that's how it is. That's how the sport has been growing, and that's how it's going to go on. And the bowlers have to just get tougher and find ways to get wickets. That's all.
So do you think a 5-wicket hole means it is as good as scoring a century?
I think it's more than a century. Especially if it's a fast bowler getting 5 wickets, it's definitely more than a century.
Which means you are getting the wickets of 5 people who could have scored century on the other side. All right, great. The next thing is, we are only talking about the T20 cricket. 3-over, watching a movie-like experience and coming up. You think Test cricket, the name itself, because it tests the caliber of a person over 5 days. Do you think Test cricket is in danger? Because till then now, you played for Test cricket and not for the 2020, it was not there. But it was said that Test cap is the ultimate thing.
100% agree to it. Do you think T20 cricket is great?
Fun-wise, yes. Entertainment-wise.
Yeah. For you, it is not for us. Professor, being a cricketer, never agree to that. And now allow my son to play T20 also. So if you want to play real cricket, you've got to play 3 to 4 days.
We got to that point because in Under-19, now the Under-19 World Cup is happening, and there was a plan of starting a 2020 version, and 90% of that committee members said, no, we'll not spoil our kids. Now, what happens when a kid learns flamboyant 2020 style when he's 13, 14? How it could spoil him?
It'll definitely spoil him. He's trying something else, what he's not doing. He doesn't have to do, and you can't go that and do it in a 5-day game. 5-day game, you've got to stay there. You have to be Rahul Dravids, you have to be Lakshmans. You can't go there and be Sehwags. Sehwag played long,
yes.
Nothing to take away from him, but because of his talent, he lasted not many last year.
Okay, so and this, we got to see one picture wherein you were assisting our women cricketers, the girls as well. How do you see the transition in Indian women's cricket today?
Major. It's gone from leaps to bounds, you can say. It is really a very good thing BCA has done. They encourage them so well, and even what they give them, there's no difference at all nowadays in women's cricket. They get the same stay, they get the same 5-star hotels, all facilities, and you see, we coaches who have done BCA, we are coaching them now. But before, nobody used to bother with them also. And even the money-wise, it's increased a lot. So everything has been changed for them, and it's good to see them, and I hope not they do much better and increase it further for them.
Yeah, it's good at least to a level where a small girl would pick up a bat and say, I would want to become a cricketer.
Especially someone like Andhra, like Kerala, when I went to Wayanad. There was somebody, auto driver's daughter, who's so cool, Sajana, her name is. She's a state captain now. She was, I seen her, she's only 15-year-old, and I was doing IDBI. So I was part of IDBI there, the first morning. And I gave her batting, and today she's got already 300s.
300s, all right, okay. And she's an auto driver's daughter.
She's an auto driver's daughter. And
she's playing for Andhra now?
Kerala.
Kerala,
captain of Kerala.
She's captain. Team,
yes.
Oh, alright. Okay, thank you. Alright, that's it from our side. We'll open the floor for the audience question as well as we have got guests here. So, quick questions. You can shoot your questions at Mr. David Johnson. Can we have the questions? We'll pass the mic.
Yeah.
this will get into this will get into YouTube as well. So yeah, we got lecturers, we got students here. You can ask questions. This is once in a lifetime opportunity, I suppose. Yeah.
David, we've got a lot of, as it's already told by a friend here, we've got a lot of this tennis ball cricket. Do you think these skills will help us at least? Maybe probably spotting the ball and so on is fine, but then when it comes to fast bowling and so on, I don't know whether the skills match for the leather ball cricket.
So unfortunately, those days we could not afford, like I said, tennis, to play leather ball. So we were forced to play tennis ball. So nowadays, what we recommend, if you can, and the academies and the state is taking care of you, we'll be to definitely bowl with a leather ball.
We are extremely happy that we are going to begin the cricket academy here, along with Karavali Academy, and we are all set to make new innings at St Aloysius College. Of course, this was not just the entry point into cricket. We have, like Brian and others, have played cricket, and of course Rahul is at the moment playing cricket for the country. He's from St. Aloysius College, but then we see here a lot of budding youngsters. I see small children coming up here, and our own students, after 13 years, they won the intercollegiate competition recently, and I would like to congratulate all of them. It comes at the right time, when we are all setting the stage for the new cricketers at St. Aloysius College. I would also have a great dream for our students. As you said, I would take it from you, the hard work and the passion, nothing else. And we say we require this facility and that facility. Yes, we require definitely, but nothing goes along with the passion. If you don't have a passion, and if you give everything, I don't think you can make it along. Whereas you have made it for a very, very long time. And that is the endurance that kept you going. My request or urge to my students here at this moment is only that. Have the discipline and passion. We would like to give you all that you can, but you must really have that passion to come in the morning and have that discipline and work hard. And definitely you will make it for a big stage, and that is our wish at St. Aloysius College. I would like to specially thank the Karavali Sports and Cricket Academy for supporting us, and also Mr. David Johnson for coming over here to inaugurate such a wonderful academy at St. Aloysius College. Thank you. God bless us.
Thank you, Father. My request, Father Rector, to make his presidential remarks.
Good evening, everybody. Dear Mr. David Johnson, Father Pravin Mark is the principal of the St. Aloysius College. Mr. Brian Price and Mr. Dayanand Pangera, Mrs. Savita and her sister, and all those who are involved with the Karavali Cricket Academy, the coaches, and my dear students, members of the staff, and my dear students. I'm happy today because we had a dream. Father Praveen and I used to say we need to have something to be done for the sports and games in our college. And the year we have thought, it's already happening. And one of the biggest things is that St. Aloysius College has won the cricket tournament of the university for the first time in 13 years. And this is something very big. I congratulate the entire team. They had some tough games. I suppose they withstood all the pressure and they really played well. And on this day, when our friend David Johnson is here to inspire us, thank you so much for coming. I think more than what you've said, we know that your life itself is a good example of discipline and passion for the game. Friends, don't think that it's going to be just easy. You've got a lot of struggle to put in. And if you are disciplined and if you keep on with that discipline, you're going to make it. I remember some years ago, Rahul Dravid used to come to our grounds. I used to be the principal of St. Joseph's Indian High School in Bangalore. And Rahul Dravid used to come there to practice it was much before I was principal, of course, that he was there. He used to come there for practice. They should reach early. And when they reached early, apparently their coach, I think is KK Tharapur or something. KK Tharapur, yeah. He, by the time he comes, the boys already used to gather. And he had always told them to do a little practice, do a little warm up before he comes. But none of the boys would listen. They would wait till the last minute. It was only this boy, Rahul Travut, would, you know, tie a string to the branch of the tree with a ball there, and the ball would go on hitting the ball, going on practicing like that, no? And the other boys would only look at him and laugh at him. And we know the result. We know the result. And the discipline of that man, Rahul Travut, was such that he wouldn't even go partying if there's got a match the following day. You know, that kind of discipline he had. And that is why he has become the coach of the Indian team today. I'm glad to know that he's a major fight, and he definitely vouches by whatever he has learned from St. Joseph's. And this is the kind of quality you need to have right from the start. Even if you're playing, whether you get a chance to get into the team or not, and I'm sure the steps that we have taken to start the Karavali Cricket Academy, I wish them all the best, that's going to definitely lead us that way, that path. We've had a lot of discussions with Santosh, who came to me also earlier. And I'm sure Karavali Cricket Academy, along with the St. Aloysius Cricket Academy, will do a wonderful job and bring up great cricketers. Many more Rahuls, should I say, or many more. You have got your own identity, whatever your names are. And you're going to shine as cricketing stars. Let this be a grand beginning. May God bless us all. Thank you.
The last part of this first half of the program, I should say, Mr. Ashwin is here. We can have the vote of thanks. He is a coach in Karavali Cricket Academy.
Good evening, everyone. It's a pleasure to express gratitude to all those who have worked to the success of this event. Special thanks to our chief guest, Mr. David Johnson, has shown his goodwill to support the emerging cricketers of Mangalore for being a part of this function. Thank you, sir. Big thank to you, Father Melwin Pinto, Father Pravin Martis, and PD Arun D'Souza, for entire management of St. Aloysius College for collaborating with the Karavali Cricket Academy. And I also thank the media and all the parents and the cricket lovers. And we are encouraged by the presence of our guest, Mr. Dayanand Bangera, Mr. Jayaprakash Shetty, and Mr. Shanti Mohan, Mrs. Savita Miskin, and all the budding cricketers and cricket lovers. Thank you all, and looking forward to your support in all our programs. Thank you so much.